The 45 tablets were all from a giant facilitated by Mrs. Valerie Trim Lowe, a St. Lucian who saw the need for such a donation and also cares about the well-being of the diaspora.
Today is the end product of a year plus of telephone calls and emails between my very good friend Mrs. Valerie Trim Lowe, St. Lucian, who currently lives in Illinois with her husband. And she is an educator. So with the diaspora, as we know, giving, always giving, she was able to request that a grant be given to the schools of St. Lucia. So she wrote to a certain company and she was given the grant of 45 tablets. With her own resources, she was able to get the tablets from Illinois to New York, from New York to St. Lucia, and clear the tablets. You understand the Ministry of Education, who gave us the brokerage services, and just the some fees were paid, but you know, not gorget fees. And the tablets have been out, and now today they are going to be presented to the principals of 5 schools within the Castries Grosselier basins. The schools are the Grosselier Infant, the Vidbutai Infant, the Mondidor combined, the Anglican Infant and the Anglican Primary. So these 45 tablets are distributed among those 5 schools, and the principals are here. Be happy to see that they are here to receive those tablets. We're hoping for the ministry officials to be here, but we have the Ambassador for Diaspora Affairs, Mrs. Justin Fletcher, who is here because today happens to be the first day of regular programming for my Rooftropics Media radio and TV online broadcast platform. And we figure that, I mean, the best person, Jocelyn, has Mrs. Fletcher, has been in talks with me for quite a while regarding having an online broadcast platform for the diaspora.
Principals of the various schools which are recipients of the tablets expressed their gratitude for the gesture.
We are so thankful. District 2 principals are here, and of course we join in with Grosselier Primary, and we're so thankful that this organization has come on board to work with us. There are so many students that are in need, and we are so happy that now a few more children will be able to be online, especially in the situation that we are in right now. And we're so, so very thankful. A heartfelt thank you to the organization.
We have to continue with the online platform. Many students will be using these devices so that they can continue their education. So we are indeed very grateful for this.
The Ambassador for Diaspora Affairs in St. Lucia, Dr. Jocelyn Clark Fletcher, endorsed Russell Lake's newly launched radio station, which will, according to her, have a further outreach across the entire diaspora.
It's only 2 years and a few months that this office has been set up wholly and solely for the first time that the diaspora has their own ambassador, not with CARICOM or OECS or with Cuba or anything. It's just diaspora, and we have been engaging with them. But all we have as communication is emails and the St. Lucia Diaspora Affairs Unit Facebook page. Okay, we have a diaspora resource team that is set up in St. Lucia. It's made up of heads of all these organizations that are important to the diaspora. They meet with the USLOA, the Union of St. Lucia Overseas Associations, quarterly. We have the St. Lucia International Association here with a Northern and Southern group, which is a group of St. Lucians who have returned to St. Lucia. And the diaspora don't know that all of this is happening to them, even if we send out information by emails and so on, because we don't have this medium. We don't have the funding either, because this office has not been, we don't have our own budget yet. We don't have our staffing. The office is made up of an ambassador and a junior officer. So, and yet we have been increasing the database from 2,000 something to 57,000 and emailing them. This radio station is going to increase that database, increase the engagement, especially as we're about to build a diaspora portal where the diaspora can put in their information, where they can also apply for driver's license, apply for birth certificates, apply for banking information and everything on that diaspora portal. And they can get responses immediately.
The two-prong activity took place at Russell's rooftop at Mondidor on Monday. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Busquet.